Good morning, Year 11s. Helping got in first on the chat. Do you know about year 10s actually race to get on the chat these days? Right. Okay, guys. So today's lesson, I'm just waiting for my other YouTube video to start. Atty's in the house. Right. Okay, guys. So today's lesson, actually, I don't really mind. The quality of the sound's actually not too bad. I'm not using my nice microphone today. Hola, Amani. Hola. Right. So I'll get rid of my YouTube video. I've popped out the chat so you guys are there, which is great. Let me know if any static breaks out. It shouldn't do now that I've got rid of my splitter. But I still have my other camera attached through the USB port. So I'll switch over now to my other camera. Boom, my clip cam. Boom! Ha ha! Mr. Duncan, super cool. Super cool. Okay, so share screen. Today's lesson, it's going to be a cracking lesson today, folks. See what I did there? A cracking lesson. Yeah, we're going to do some serious cracking. Okay, so yeah, lesson four. Oh, I need my learning objectives. I've put them onto my YouTube video. Grab that. Hello. Hello. iGCSE, organic and Argon Yorkshire. Lesson four, I believe. I think this is lesson four. Yeah, lesson four, yeah. Title is cracking. Okay, I'll switch my tablet into tablet mode. There we go. Whoa. Uh-oh, I just totally ruined. I've got my little fan sitting next to my computer. I've got to have that because my laptop, then otherwise it overheats. And so I hope it should be okay. Let me know if it's really affecting the sound and I'll try and move it around to try and make sure it doesn't. Okay, so three learning objectives, why we crack, how we crack, and what products are formed. Cool. Okay, title is cracking. So we've, for the last like three lessons, we started off with doing some nomenclature. So we were talking about naming, and we looked through this, crude oil containing alkanes. And then we moved into combustion, and we were talking about the fact that we burn them. You know, the primary use of most organics is fuels. Now, no difference in sound. Excellent. Mr. Duncan, are you are cracking me up. See what you did there. See what you did. Yeah, so we talked about the idea of a fuel, a substance that you can burn to or react with oxygen to release energy. One of the things I haven't talked about is carbon sinks. I might mention a little bit of that today. But today, and then we went into how we solve pollution. I even mentioned the catalytic converter on cars. And today's lesson, we're moving on to cracking. Okay, so crude oil is a non-renewable resource. What does that actually mean? Non-renewable, it cannot be replaced once used. So other non-renewable resources, always nice to mention this, other non-renewable resources include metals, stroke metal ores, how nasty, the oil is cruel. Oh, cruel oil. Oh no. I don't know why I did it. I said crude. I definitely said crude. Metal ores. I'm also going to mention natural gas as well. Just to also say that nuclear is also non-renewable. Did I just get ignored? Ouch. What did Ashley say? Hi, Ms. Duncan. Hi, Ashley. Ashley, I don't think this is, you're not meant to be in this lesson, right? Aren't you? You're in the other class. Are you joining for fun? Is Ashley meant to be here? Am I like completely off base there? Damn. Hi, Ashley. She's in our class. Oh, just ignore me then. How did I manage to skip you on the register then? W-Y-M, Mr. Duncan, she's always here. Oh, I don't know. She wasn't, didn't do on the register. I'm sorry. Nuclear is also non-renewable, Mr. Duncan, I'm hurt. Oh, don't be hurt, Ashley. Oh, come on. Give me a break. Got so many kids. Oh. Just focus on the cruel oil. That's all you need to do, Ashley. Just focus on the cruel oil. So, non-renewable resource. Next thing to mention is crude oil. Crude oil contains fractions. We need to define Mr. Duncan equals cruel. Ah, oh, Tiff, that's so mean. So fractions, a group of molecules of similar size and reactivity. So for example, e.g. petrol. Crude oil like more cruel oil. E.g. petrol. Petrol is a fraction. E.g. petrol. Now, petrol itself, can I just mention now key bullet points here, nota bene? Yeah, fractions have a range of boiling points, BPTs. A range, I'd be okay with me writing BPTs. You're not allowed to do that on your exam, by the way. Had a student do that once upon a time. Have a range of boiling points. So for example, e.g. petrol, the boiling point range is between 60 degrees to about 110, give or take 110 degrees. And they commonly ask at GCSE, so I'll put that in a bubble, nota bene. Yeah, they commonly ask this at GCSE. Does it explain why a fraction's got a range of boiling points? Question, explain why the petrol fraction has a range of boiling points. So your answers to this, bullet point number one, answer. Number one, petrol contains molecules of different lengths. I'm going to put C6 to C10. The range, bullet point number two, the lowest number in the range is the BPT, the boiling point of the smallest molecule. And largest BPT, longest molecule. That's it. Three boiling points. Three bullet points. Oh, dearie me. And I'd always give the example. If I was doing that in an exam, I'd do C6 will be 60 degrees Celsius and C10 would be 110 degrees Celsius. And all the others in the between. At that point, you gain all the marks. So it has a range because different length molecules have different boiling points, which is nice. Okay, so the next thing to realize is that the fractions aren't infinite. So you can actually be given this data. So there are actually different types of crude oil out there. You can have Canadian crude oil. you can have Middle Eastern crude oil, and they all have different ratings and how valuable they are, depending on the percentages of different fractions. However, the most important thing here is to realize that the petrol fraction, is demanded more than any other, It has the highest demand. I bet the Canadian is very nice, not cruel. The Canadian crude oil actually is a very, very, it's called a heavy crude oil because it contains a lot of longer chains, much more tar-like. It's very, very thick. Doesn't contain, contains a tiny percentage of the shorter chains. So, but they have lots and lots. These are called the Canadian oil sands, if you're interested. It's where they've got beaches that are just covered in crude oil. Check it out. Canadian oil sands. Canadian oil sands images. They have huge expanses where the sand is full of oil. And they're black. They're sometimes referred to as the black sands of Canada. Alberta banking on an oil sand boom. And the sand is full of all the really long alkanes that have high boiling points. All the shorter ones have evaporated. But what they do is they extract the long chains, the long chain fractions from the sand, and then they crack it. And we're coming to cracking now. So the petrol fraction is demanded more than any other. In 1939, World War II, WW2, broke out. And the demand for petrol, for the petrol fraction, petrol fraction skyrockets. They're building planes, boats, cars. Do you think swimming in tar is safe? Asking for a friend. Are they open for tourists? No, it wouldn't be safe at all. It's also got benzene in it, which is highly carcinogenic. And also, you'd probably get stuck at you. This stuff is really, really, really thick. Like, to the point where you wouldn't really be able to swim in it. It would just, you'd just get all stuck and you'd probably then die. You'd sink into the tar and then you'd be preserved forever. And so then we'd find you 40,000 years later preserved like a woolly mammoth. Yeah. Skyrockets. Now, the problem was the demand for petrol was now exceeded by, was it, no, hang on. The demand exceeded the supply. The demand for petrol was now exceeded the supply from crude oil. There wasn't enough petrol in crude oil. Crude oil contains anywhere from 1% to about, I think, 16% for the really, really good stuff. Some of them contain as high as 16. I think the most common percentage is 8. We can have a look. So let's do oil fraction percentages. Cool. Let's go for that one. So there we go. So petrol, there you go, about 15%. No, yes, 25%. Wow, that's really high. Let's try that one. Light end, where's light naphthene? Where's petrol? See, that's gasoline. Orange. Yeah, so it does vary. Look at this one. Don't like that one. It's a horrible picture. Let's try this one. Nuclear, that doesn't make any sense anyway. There we go. There's a different one. So you can see it varies quite a lot depending on the oil that you have. But there isn't really a huge amount of petrol in it. That's the orange wedge, as you can see from that diagram. If I click on that one and then zoom in on this, there we go. So the petrol quantity is relatively small. And of course, we used it all up. We were using copious amounts of petrol, and we still do today. Now, what this now meant was that there wasn't enough of the short chains. So this now brings a very important question. This now brings the second of our exam questions. Question number two. Why do we crack? Yeah, why do we crack? And the answer is, the demand for short alkanes exceeds the supply. That is why we crack. So at this point, I'm going to play a YouTube video. Yeah, I'm going to play a YouTube video within YouTube whilst streaming. That's weird, isn't it? Yo, job. Oh, actually, I don't need to. I think I have this video. Let's just do a quick search for cracking. Oh no. Oh no. Oh. Uh-oh, it's not letting me play it. Oh no. Oh, that's awkward. I'll just go away, will you? Uh-oh, busted. Open with? Oh. Open with more apps. It's not gonna play it. Doesn't play it. Oh no. I need to let's see if I can find the video. That's the video though. That's definitely not what I want. Cracking crude oil. Oh, there it is.
Need a professional website? I created one for our startup using Wix.
Come on, skip.
When increasing use of motor cars pyramided the demand for gasoline to extraordinary heights, scientists were called upon to devise new methods. How could a greater proportion of gasoline be extracted from the crude oil than that obtained from the fractionating tower alone? To meet this challenge, the scientists turned to products other than gasoline, which are drawn from the crude, studied their molecules, and found a way to change them, to turn them into gasoline. The result was cracking. Let's look at a diagram of a cracking plant. Here we see how one part of petroleum that is not gasoline is converted into gasoline. Called gas oil, it is pumped through a pipe into a cracking furnace, heated to over 900 degrees under tremendous pressure. And the individual particles, molecules, are broken into smaller molecules, just as coal is broken under a hammer. If we could see one of those molecules, it would look something like this. The hotter the molecule gets, the faster it wiggles, until finally it wiggles so fast, it flies apart. The pieces shoot around at great speeds. They eventually find partners and form new and smaller molecules that look something like this. These smaller molecules are now no longer gas oil, but are gasoline of high-powered, noxious quality. Some of the gas oil molecules do not fly apart and must be separated from the gasoline. This is done in the bubble tower. Here, the big molecules, which are not gasoline, are held back and come up.
There we go. So there is only one reason why we crack. They can ask you for others, by the way. So, but this is the top answer, and I need you guys to understand that. This is really, really important. That is the reason why we crack. Yeah. There is another point I'd probably make here, which is you get another, I don't even want to add it. That's the answer to the question. They could ask you for two reasons. That is the number one reason. There is a second reason, reason two. But I want you to realize that this is really important, that this is not the number one reason. If they ask you for one reason, the only reason is because of the demand exceeds the supply. Hi, Uma. So reason number two, alkenes are also made. And alkenes are used to make polymers and alcohol. We'll come across that later. But that, I want you to realize that I'm really saying, do not say this one unless they force you into it. Yeah, don't say this unless they force you into two of them. Yeah, this is why. Yeah, I need you guys to get that. I would be attempting my IGCSE today, 2 hours, and it is chemistry today. Good luck, Uma. Good luck. We're just covering cracking. I don't know if that's going to be on your test or not. I wish you all the best of luck. Have a look at my paper one review from January 2019. Might be worthwhile you having a look if you're doing your 2-hour paper, which would be the paper one. Might be useful. Okay, so that's why we crack. So what we now need to do is say how we crack. So how do we crack? Do we crack? Okay, and I'm just gonna bullet point this partly for Uma's benefit. So how do we crack? Number one, temperatures, high temps. Number one, high temp. About, give or take, 650 degrees Celsius. Really hot. Yeah, thank you very much. You have helped me a lot. Oh, you're very welcome. High temperatures, 650 degrees Celsius. Next, number two, we need a catalyst. And that catalyst is called zeolite, and you do have to say it. You can actually call it other things as well. The one that's actually on, you can actually call it aluminosilicates as well if you prefer, but I just prefer zeolite. It's easier. Aluminosilicate. You can't put alumin silicate, they'll penalize you though. That one has to be spelt properly, which is why I don't like it very much. I think you can also say just say the word silicates, but I don't like it. Just stick with zeolite. It's by far the better response. The third one is the absence of air. Three, absence of air. Because if you take crude oil to 650 degrees Celsius in the presence of air, it's going to catch fire. No matter how you take it, guys, it's going to set fire. It's going to react with oxygen. So those are your three conditions. And we now get a practical picture that we have to draw. So here's how this works. We need a boiling tube. Oh, wasn't quite perfect enough. There we go, need a boiling tube. And in the middle of the boiling tube, we're gonna add some catalyst chips. These are our zeolite chips. Zeolite catalyst. Catalyst. Right, at the bottom, we're going to put some glass wool. Yeah, this is glass wool. Glass wool soaked. Soaked in, and this is where we now pick up a particular fraction. Soaked in paraffin. Or sometimes referred to, paraffin of course is the same as diesel, annoyingly. But just to mention, by the way, we don't actually crack paraffin. This is just a practical that we do in school. The one that we crack in industry, we crack naphthalene. We crack naphtha, which is why they say the petrochemical industry. I have no idea, by the way, why my laptop is constantly bringing up the keyboard. I don't know why, guys. I'm just gonna clean my screen a little bit. Maybe that's got something to do with it. Hopefully that'll stop doing it now. Right, so this is soaked in paraffin. So I'm gonna soak this in paraffin, make that orange. There we go, soaked in paraffin. Right, now what we're going to do is we're going to seal it. We're going to have a delivery tube. What we're going to do is we're going to seal this with a cork with a delivery tube on it. There we go. And then what we're going to do is we're going to feed that underwater. Whoop. Oh, it wasn't perfect, but it'll do. Now, what we're going to do is, I'm actually going to move the glass wool bit. I'm going to rewrite that above it. This is a glass wool. By the way, you don't use cotton wool because the cotton wool will just react with it. You'll break down the cotton wool and it'll turn into carbon. So we use glass wool because it won't melt. Glass wool soaked in paraffin. You can just put long chain alkane. Now what we're going to do is we're going to heat it. We're going to heat both the oil, and what's going to happen is the paraffin, we're going to heat the paraffin. I'm going to change my arrow, make it a little bit shorter. There you go. The paraffin will change from a liquid, and it will turn the paraffin into a gas. Paraffin becomes a gas. So we're going to boil it. Wow, humans are so crazy. How can you make glass wool? Oh, that's a very good question, Atia. Humans are so crazy. Yeah, it's really funny, actually. So when you take glass and so it's actually really easy to do. If you take a glass rod, and you heat it in the middle until it glows red, you can then pull it apart and it will stretch it. It'll stretch it into very thin fibers. And if you keep going, just keep pulling it, you'll form really thin, hair-like strands of glass, which is actually really flexible. Go figure. I know. Really weird, that. I'll show you that when we're in school next. So let me know when I can do that for you. We can do it in class. It's always a bit of fun. Got to be careful with glass wool, because it's very sharp and not very nice. Oh, DIY recipe. Thank you, Mr. Duncan. Nah. Yeah, I can do that with you. Right, so now what we're going to do, what's going to happen, we're going to bubble this underwater, and we're going to collect the gas with fluid displacement. And we're going to collect the gas that we now generate. So what happens is the crude oil now passes over the catalyst, and when it hits the catalyst, it now gets cracked. It gets cracked at the surface, and we now saw it's actually a really cool reaction to do this, because you actually get to see it happening at the surface. It's really cool. So you heat the catalyst, and you also, by the way, you heat the liquid and you also heat the catalyst. It's always nice to do that. Heat the paraffin and heat the catalyst. Now what's happening here is this. You start off with something like C12H double it and add 2. 24, 26. And what's going to happen is it's going to break apart. And what we're going to get is shorter pieces. I'm going to get C8H double it and add 2, 18. And chances are, I'm now also going to get, so this, now we started off with a long alkane, a long chain alkane. We now have a short chain alkane. Short chain alkane, and I also get something else, which is very special. We now get an alkene. Now, in this case, the most common one is ethene, and I'm going to have to double that to balance the equation. Because conservation of mass, whatever goes in must come out. 12 carbons went in, 8 came out in petrol, short chain alkane, in this case, petrol, which is what we're after. But we also now get a short chain alkene as well. A short chain alkene. Now the reason for this is because when you break it apart, if we go super simple, by the way, just to mention that adding up, 12 carbons went in, 12 carbons went in, 12 carbons must come out. This molecule contains 8 and this molecule contains 2. Well, if you add those together, that's 10. So we're going to need 2 of those to get to the 12. You always tend to get multiple alkenes out of this. A single short chain, but then multiple alkenes. So you can get all kinds of products in reality. We're very good at this now. I'm just going to give you an exam question. I'm tempted to actually find one, but I won't. Exam question number 3. So write the equation. Write the cracking equation for nonane forming pentane and one other product. Very common GCSE. So what they're testing you on is, number one, can you draw nonane? So the answer is C9H, double it and add 2, 18, so 20. Cracking, we've got 650 degrees Celsius, zeolite cat, no air. Right, so what we're now going to form is pentane, C5H, double it and add 2, 10, 12, and one other product. Right, well, what's the difference is 5, so I'm going to get C4H, what's the difference? So 20 and 12, so 8. So I've actually got butene as my byproduct. Byproduct. Is that how you spell byproduct? Is it byproduct? No, it's by with a Y, isn't it? Byproduct? Yeah. Yeah. Because byproduct, and then that, you guys can help me out with that one. So that would be the end of that equation. If it said two other products, if this question here was then to say this bit here, actually then said, I'm going to just do replacement here. If it said, if this said two other products, what you could do is you would do C5H12 plus 2 C2H4s. You could do that. Yeah? Does that make sense? So clever questions, because the question is directing you to what they want you to be making. And they're trying to analyze whether or not you understand that you're actually going to get a variety of products. We make loads of them in reality. Loads of different products. There's loads of different types of cracking as well now, but that's A level. But not particularly complicated. You've got to know the diagram. Yeah. Got to know the diagram. I need to actually mention something really awkward here, which is called suck back. This is actually probably the most dangerous practical that I do in class, with a full class. You guys are in pairs when you do this and you set this whole thing up. And when you heat up the crude oil, when you heat up the paraffin and you start collecting the gas, one of the things that students are quite scared of is you're making this incredibly hot. And what happens is the gas that's coming out of the tubes here, often if you don't heat it strongly enough, the water will start to be sucked back up the tube. And if the water then hits, if the water makes it all the way up, if the water makes it all the way up this tube and gets in, the whole thing will explode and, well, you'll just kill everyone in the room. Amazing. This is called suck back. And it's a really difficult, like, it's one of those things which is a bit awkward, because the way you fix it is by heating it more strongly, which students don't want to do. I've had students who have realized that the water has nearly got to the tube and they just drop their Bunsen burner and they leg it. And that's the worst thing you can do. All you actually do is just heat it more strongly and you'll push the water back out. But of course, it's kind of counterintuitive. It's a bit scary when you do it. It's great practical work. It's great. And I've had a couple of them explode in the past. But as long as you're wearing goggles and protective gear, you're absolutely fine. Anyway, so amazingly, that actually brings us to the end of cracking. So I will post a homework sheet. So why we crack? Supply is exceeded by the demand. Number two, how we crack? High temperatures. Hi, Mita. Nice to see you. High temperatures, 650 degrees Celsius, zeolite catalyst, no air. What products are formed? A shorter alkane and a short alkene. Now, just to say, because these are the ones in demand, but it's also nice for me to mention, why do we like, here's another exam question. Exam question number four. Why do we prefer shorter chain? hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons, question mark. The answer, number one, they are more useful. Isn't that weird? I don't like the answer, but it's one of the correct ones in the mark schemes. They are more useful. Why are they more useful, guys? Yeah, they are more useful. They burn better. They burn more cleanly. More cleanly. That's two words. Looks like deanly. Burn more cleanly because they require less oxygen to burn completely. Yeah, so they're better fuels. Yeah, more useful. Burn more cleanly. Better fuels. That'll do. So why do we prefer them? Those are the reasons. Burn better, better fuels, more useful. More, by the way, when you say more useful, in reality, you're saying that more vehicles use it. And I think you'd all agree with that. Most of the vehicles in Malaysia are powered by petrol. Very few are powered by diesel. Yeah, so they're more useful. They're used in more, they're used by more vehicles, if you wish. And that brings me to the end of my lesson. What products are formed, and we're done. Which is nice, it's the end of cracking. Isn't that lovely? Isn't that lovely? So, I'll bring you guys back. Guys, it's been really good to see you all. That's the end of cracking. I'll post the worksheet on the classroom on it, so you can have a look. And I will see you guys soon. See you later, guys.